So there's a new viral threat going on. Normally I'm not so much into these chainlet equivalents on today's social media, but this one really hit me. I'm talking about hashtag MeToo. A hashtag that does more to people than putting some cold ice water over their heads. I mean, that was all fun and you know, the feels were even better. And it sure helps to put ALS on the attention span in this world where we only can concentrate on content if it really hits us. Well, this one really hits me. You know, hashtag MeToo is quite something different. All of a sudden, it's about all of us, women and men. And for those of you who've missed it, people are sharing an awareness hashtag called hashtag MeToo. They bring a voice to sexual assault. Just by saying out loud makes it more real. And it's been hidden for so many people for so long. People share it on different social platforms like Facebook and all that. Some of them share a piece of the story and most of them don't. I mean, I get that. And that's of course all right. It is something that is probably one of the most difficult things to talk about because, you know, we live in a shame culture. I mean, we censor films and series so we don't see a boob after they had sex. But it's plain normal to see people getting blown to pieces and pieces of brain splattering all over you and stuck into the lens. Now, I don't know about you, but I've seen more boobs in my life than splattered brains. And thinking about that, what is more fucked up, right? So yes, we do live in a shame culture where sex is something we don't talk about. And in most of the times, it's not necessary to talk about it because it's all good. And I'm all for doing it instead of talking about it, of course. But there are cases when we do need to talk about it, when things are going wrong, when people get depressed, when people get harassed, when they get assaulted, get raped. Sexual harassment is almost a part of our culture. I mean, it happens so often. And yes, most of the times by men. So we need to make sure that those men are being taught the right thing. Let me tell you one thing if you're watching this. Never say to a woman something that you don't want another man telling you when you're in jail. Think about that. No, and even if you think it's funny or, you know, it's just a joke. I mean, yes, she's cute. Sure, she's got a nice rack. Sure, she's dressed all sexy and all that. So, she didn't do that for you. She did it for herself. Not for you to make some stupid comment about that. So, you know, don't. And harassment is of course, something that should be taken, you know, out of the shame and shadow of friendly touches. I really resent that. And don't get me wrong, I mean, I love women and I love touching them, hugging them and feeling their femininity within my space. But you know, it's the intent and the consent that matters most of all. I teach men how to seduce women. That's what I do. And yes, touching is a big part in that. So I teach my men that the touching should be in a way that they feel safe, that they feel protected and appreciated instead of, you know, groped and creeped out, grabbing parts that's off limits and, you know, simply being harassed. So yes, I want to say a big respect to all women and men that share their MeToo hashtag. Let's bring this to the surface, into the open. Not your personal story per se. I mean, you deal with that the way you want. Please do take action against these predators and talk to people you trust about what happened. Know that it is never your fault how other people behave. That is their responsibility. Hashtag MeToo. Raise your hands and know that you're not alone. Raise your hands and combine the strength of your synergy. And let's keep communicating. Get out of that shame culture. Sex is something we should all be happy about, not be ashamed about. Never, ever. So to all of you MeToo hashtaggers, I have the deepest respect for your guts to show yourself. And know, I see you.